The five-year response plan was developed by the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development with support from other ministries and development partners. The plan will be implemented in 13 refugee hosting districts, including Yumbe, Koboko, Terego, Madiokolo, Ubongi and Adjumani in West Nile. Other districts are Chikube, Kiryandongo, Chegegwa, Isinjiro, Lamo, Kampala and Kamwenje.
People stay amicably in peace with the community should stay, the host community should stay well with the refugees. Secondly is the social kind of stay which is in these camps should be really rectified and people have all that social systems correctly. Then another one is the economic system which is in the camps, which should be handled correctly by the two sides, the host community and the refugees.
So we want to look at a situation where refugees and host communities coexist and develop as one. We want peaceful coexistence among them. We want them to benefit from all government and development programs. We want them to improve on their livelihoods by increasing on production, food security. At the end of it all, they will have fought poverty.
Sophia Mbui Wanjigi, the Senior Protection Officer at the United Nations High Commission for Refugees, Yumbe Office, said the donor funds have dwindled, causing a lot of social issues among the refugees and the host communities, like domestic violence, defilement, rape, drug abuse, hunger, and malnutrition.
We work with is strengthening cooperation and solidarity between refugees and host communities and host governments and working together. We always talk about this humanitarian peace development nexus. And this response plan goes to the heart of that nexus. Truly, this is the one response plan that encapsulates all those things together.
Solomon Orskan, the refugee desk officer in West Nile region, says job creation and livelihood is the most significant option for sustainable refugee response. He says refugees need land so they can start producing their own food and selling the extra to get income.
And you know, donor funding is dwindling everywhere. So that makes us think that why can't refugees produce more for themselves as the donor is sneezing and saying this, maybe that epidemic might catch you. So we are glad that WFP is supporting us and we are moving forward. Certainly over the period of time, you must be aware COVID was one of our challenges. There are also challenges of weather pattern. Sometimes rain does not come the way we think it should come because we are dependent on rain-fed agriculture. There are problems of pests and diseases. And of course,
these youth engage more in drug abuse and suicidal tendencies because they are idle. But if we have a plan like this that will effectively involve them, then we hope we shall score in that line.
Story by Adam Gule for the news.